Hello everyone and welcome to this new video. Today I'm going to show you how you can make your airport more realistic in 6 steps. Let's go to step 1. GSE. GSE or ground service equipment are the catering vehicles, pushback trucks, baggage carts, etc. You get it. It brings a lot of life to your airport and at every model airport store they will sell GSE. But I think it's a bit expensive, so keep that in mind. But you can find cheaper GSE, and you can usually do that by people who are selling their airport and ask them if they can sell their GSE to you, and this way you will get more GSE for a lower price. Step 2. Tire marks. Tire marks are found at every real-world airport and they are caused by the airplane's rubber tires. Tire marks are usually found at turns, as you can see right here, and they are actually really easy to make. The only thing you need is a pencil and start soft and go rougher to get the optimal result. Step 3. An ILS system. Each and every big airport in the world uses an ILS or instrument landing system. This system guides the aircraft safely to the runway. I printed out the red and white box and made the two poles by bamboo skewer. I could make a tutorial on how to make them and let me know in the comments if you want that. Step 4. Ground marks. Ground marks are found at all airports and they are really easy to make. There are several, like runway ahead, which lets you know that there is a runway ahead of you. No entry, which tells you that you are not allowed to enter that taxi or runway. And max wingspan, which defines which aircraft can or cannot enter a certain ramp by the width of their wings. I made the marks myself in a Word document and then printed them out and glued them on my airport. Step 5. A correct setup. Having a correct setup is key. I tried to make a realistic one as well. Here you can see my intercontinental terminal, which is all kinds of wide bodies which are flying long haul flights. This is my European terminal, which serves the more expensive medium haul flights around Europe. And this is my holiday flight section, which serves all my holiday flights to warm destinations. And last, you see my cargo section. And next to that is also my military and private section. Step 6. Lighting. The last step is good lighting. As you can see here, there is a big difference when I have my LED strip turned on and off. I bought one for 40 euros, which can only produce cold white light, and it's a very nice addition to my airport. My airport is located in a spot which doesn't have that much natural light, so the LED strip was a great addition. And as you can see here, I just put it on the wall with tape. Well guys, that was it. Thanks for watching to this video. Please subscribe, like, and leave a nice comment. And I will see you at the next video. Bye.